how can you measure respiratory capacity during exercise? First of all, if you're interested in the topic, you need to get hold of the book Oxygen Advantage by Patrick McCone. I believe that most people intuitively know that the way they breathe during exercise is very important. But if you're not convinced, think of the following. When you're running, when do you stop? Is it when your legs get fatigued or when your lungs cannot take it anymore? Probably for most people it will be the second one. In this video, I will share with you a simple test which you can do to indicate what is your respiratory capacity during sports, but I will also give you a modification of this test so that you can tailor it more to your sport. My name is Anastasis, I'm a Buteyko Method instructor, yoga teacher, and an Oxygen Advantage instructor. I will first of all tell you that prior to doing this test, I think you should measure your control pose test. If you're not familiar with it, I will leave a link below so you can look at a video I've recorded for that. But the control pose test, you need to know before the one that I will describe because of two reasons. First of all, it's more subjective. And the second thing is because it is more indicative of how you breathe during the rest of the day. In the same way that you cannot have a poor posture for 23 hours and good posture for the 1 hour that you exercise, the same thing applies for breathing. You cannot be a bad breather for 22 hours and then 2 hours of the day be a good breather because you exercise. Let's get on now with the test. It is called breathlessness test in the Oxygen Advantage method, and it is quite straightforward. I will first describe and demonstrate, and then I will explain what's it about. So it is, as I said, quite simple. You take a normal breath in and out from your nose, and then you pinch your nose. And then you start walking, measuring the number of steps that you take. Try to take normal steps. A lot of people slow down their pace when they are holding their breath. Probably as a result of the diver's response, but either way, it doesn't matter. Just carry on walking. And what I usually say is that push yourself to the limit. I don't mind if you pass out at the end of this walk. Nobody has passed out so far. So I'll take a breath in, breath out, and then I will start walking. So. How does the breathlessness test compare to the control pose test? There are three differences. The breathlessness test puts the body under stress. Our heart rate increases as we keep walking. So it is more indicative of how we breathe when under pressure. The second one is that the breathlessness test has to do more with our upper tolerance to breathlessness, which is the point that not we start feeling breathless, but the upper limit of that. And finally, it has to do with how much we are able to push ourselves. Our ability to push ourselves will depend a little bit on personality and not so much on our respiratory capacity. But there is a similarity, of course, and this has to do that both the control pose test and the breathlessness test depend on our tolerance to carbon dioxide starting at our functional respiratory capacity. If you want to adapt this test for your sport, you can do it quite easily by taking a normal breath in, out, and then go for a set of repetitions or cover a certain distance that relate to your sport. I will give you two examples. One for boxing, where you can take a normal breath in, out, and then by holding your breath, you will not be able to pinch your nose, but you can lock your throat and take a number of punches in a bag. The second one is for swimming. So again, you can take a normal breath in, out, and then start swimming and take the maximum number of strokes you can take at the end of the exhalation, at your functional respiratory capacity. The more you improve your respiratory capacity, the longer distance you will be able to cover.